Last time on Mike Saunders Project, we watched Dungeons & Dragons, and you saw us riff it a bit. And now is the exciting conclusion where we actually do the review with our buddy Jay. Enjoy!
Well, like I said, we started watching that, and we watched it. And then we finished watching it.
And the overall consensus is...
Well, hold on a second. We're not rating it yet. No. We're not going to rate it yet. Let's talk about it a little bit.
Jumping the gun, we're going to talk about it a bit. It was boring. That's always important to mention first.
I didn't know what was going on the whole time.
No.
So what is the plot? Let me see if I can get it together, and you guys correct me if I'm wrong. So you got this wormy guy. His name is Elwood. No, his name is Jebediah. No, Ridley. So you got Ridley, and he's a white kid. And you got Marlon Wayans, right?
Known as
I don't care what that is. Then you have a dwarf named Elwood.
I think he's your favorite character, isn't he?
And he's got a character woman named Marina.
I want to see a franchise of films that's about Elwood the Dwarf and Gwildor the Dwarf.
Gwildor was a dwarf?
From He-Man.
Was Gwildor a dwarf?
I don't know. I assumed he was.
Gwildor, what are you fighting for?
So
that's where I left off. That's where I'm leaving off there. There was this guy with blue lips, and he was trying to help a wizard get control of red dragons. And that's all I can really tell you about this movie.
Wait, what is that guy's name?
His name was Leopold.
Damador? Something like that. Damodar? I think it was Damodar.
Ramadan.
Yeah, Ramadan.
So, Ramadan was like a...
Ramadan was working for the evil wizard
He was a high-level knight.
Profion.
Profius is a better name.
You're now known as Profius.
It's like Orpheus, Prolapse. But more pro. Astrid Sebian is the standby art director for this movie, and Vladimir Jezik is the set dresser.
Oh, yeah, the credits are rolling.
Wow, there's a lot of Eastern European people who work on this movie.
Herbert. Also, another plot point is... wanted everyone to be equal.
Apparently she controls and white dragons.
The evil wizard did not want that.
They were white dragons?
So he wanted to control the red dragons to attack. The dragon controls
so
red dragons.
So the white kid
Ridley.
I believed it. And Marlon Wayans, they get wrapped up in this whole plot, and they have to go find this dragon of the eye, and that's pretty much what happens. They go and do it, and they get it, and then everybody wants to kill him for it. Right? Am I talking
the bad CGI special effects?
Ridley and Snails went to go steal something from
the fuck is Snails
from
Marlon Wayans.
They went to go steal something from the Mage's Guild. Which, by the way, has absolutely no magical defenses.
Oh, I forgot about that whole scene.
They just sort of sneak in there, you know. No guards, no nothing. And they then get wrapped up in that whole thing.
Yep.
Was that the same time that Marlon Wayans got sucked into that, what did you call it, the oatmeal rug?
No, that was
Ramadan's
he
lair,
He snuck
right?
into his lair because he had his arm
oh, yeah.
there.
So does that mean he was having sex with Marina?
That's what I thought so, but they didn't imply
there was a couple things that happened in this movie where I was thinking that people were having sex.
Well, it's only PG-13, I don't know.
The dwarf...
Jong Woo Hyo.
The dwarf did that little banging motion.
Oh, he was
banging
the bar.
Dwarf women got a beard and meat you can grab onto.
And what?
Meat you can grab onto. Does he mean dicks? When he says dwarf women, does he just mean men?
Is there such thing as dwarf women?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They do have beards.
But they do, they're like men almost, like they have beards.
Wow.
Like.
And shelf bosoms.
Shelf bosoms? dwarf titties? Would you suck them?
Oh, man, I don't know.
It's that
would
beard.
You move the beard?
The beard's a little the beard's much a little. For me. That's a little much.
Just shave her beard while she's sleeping. Ooh. What does that say? Dragon Battle City background and Damdar's tentacles?
Damodar, that's the bad guy. Damodar. Just rolls off the tongue. Damodar.
So what else happened in this movie?
They fought
this
dragons.
This movie's stupid. It was really awful.
The acting was bad. It's like...
Marlon Wayans died, what, halfway through?
Oh, like three quarters of the way through, I think.
His character was awful.
Filmed entirely on location in the Czech Republic. So that's why all the Eastern European names are up there.
I don't think anybody who did this movie was familiar with D&D.
I thought the brunette chick was hot, but that doesn't really make the better. No dragons or other animals were hurt or injured during the filming of this motion picture.
Does it really? Oh my goodness, it's got wacky credits. Credits.
That's the only
credits.
That's the only wacky credit.
That's pretty wacky.
Is there anything else we gotta say?
Just some weird things, like the bar scene.
The Mos Eisley Cantina ripoff.
So, am I the only one who's, like, my mind has totally forgotten everything about this movie? Like, I'm sitting here trying to rack my brain. I remember more about Holy Mountain right now than I do about this movie. And we just watched this.
Why wasn't it rated R?
In
a good movie.
It was bland. Like, nothing really.
Yeah, happened. It was. It was,
The fights were really bland.
Oh, no, but Ripley was doing some fucking...
He did a couple of fucking sow cows.
Somersault kicks.
Triple Lutzes.
Nothing to do with the plot of the movie, but in the bar, the dwarf just yells, bar fight, and flips.
the bar fight starts.
She goes down. What are the special features?
We were going to talk about what I think they should have done.
What do you mean?
They should not have called it
Dungeons and Dragons. Oh, we were going to...
Did you say that? I thought you said that during the opening.
Yeah, I did. And then Mike said we would go back to it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's right. We were going to come up with our own titles.
I didn't even think about that at all.
Oh, me neither.
My title of this movie is... Why didn't I get to see Thor Birch's delicious... Deco?
Well, no, you were calling him sopping.
Sopping
wet bosoms?
That became a whole subplot I was talking about aloud during all the fucking... Congress scenes.
So what are you calling it again?
Why didn't I get to see Thor Birch's delicious D's?
Campaign
setting. So you'd have called it Forgotten Realms and based it off of that or something?
No,
like
maybe...
Trisit to the movie?
Some sort of name in Forgotten Realms or something to do with it. Dragonlance, that is also a campaign setting. I mean, this Dungeons & Dragons doesn't seem to attract the average person.
Yeah, well...
They should have had... blah 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 name and then the Dungeons and Dragons logo in small print someplace.
I would have called it Jeremy Irons Wacky Faces.
he really handed it up for this movie.
Which one's Jeremy Irons? The main guy?
He was the...
Oh, probably, yeah.
It's mine!
He was,
give it to me! He was like the man!
He was
somebody
like the
stop
man.
Me!
Somebody!
I wish I thought of that.
Smoking!
He was the mask. It was really bad.
He was the mask without wearing the mask. He totally wasn't. It was so funny!
Oh, we gotta throw some clips of him acting like the master.
Somebody stop me!
Give it to me!
We need clips of the dude with blue lips.
Oh, his lips were so blue.
We riffed like 30 minutes of it. The lip guy's in it, Jeremy Irons is in it, we showed everybody.
Somebody stop me! Smoking!
He's...
prepare to fight again. Move that crossbow. Somebody stop me.
He's just always doing that. Come on, Jeremy. What are the movies with Jeremy Irons in?
I don't know.
I'm not even going to look it up because who cares? I hate him. Just from
the
this.
The brunette chick owned a pretty impressive array of stupid looks to put on her stupid face.
What, which one?
The female lead, the brunette
chick.
Oh,
Marina?
The
Marina, yeah. Where you park your boat.
What was the name of the elven chick? Her armor.
I can't remember.
Her armor had boobs.
It was like
and nipples
holding.
And ab, like sort of the abdominal.
And a belly button.
A belly button. You could have fit a grape like in that belly button.
Pimento olive.
Yeah.
I think the most cringe-worthy scene in this is when the main character Ridley is talking during Snail's death.
Oh yeah,
graveyard
yeah.
scene.
Oh my goodness,
he had like his facial.
How many times did he cry or tear up in this
a
movie?
Lot.
He was tearing up left and right. He was the hero.
He's a sensitive guy, Mike.
When's the last time we watched an action movie
where the main character cries more than 5 times and he's supposed to be a hero?
Yeah,
fighter?
What the hell is that? He legit cries or tears up like at least 5 times.
And his
Mike,
hair is always
he's
so
a warrior
perfect.
Poet.
Don't you make me cry?
He's a warrior poet.
He's a warrior poet. What were you saying, Jen?
His hair is like always perfect.
Always perfect.
He made a better beautiful woman than he did badass.
Oh, Jerry was very impressed.
I thought he was beautiful.
He's like, there's two hot women here. I'm like, dude, that's a guy.
There's two.
Holy, is that a guy?
Then I started humping up on Mike and he got mad.
Yeah, because I was like, you're not my wife.
I might start doing it again at any minute.
So
I'm feeling not good.
So, oh my god. Fuck, I forgot. Oh, he's touching his groin.
As far as fan service, like D&D references and all that, they don't really do a whole lot.
No.
You know which one they did slip in that was really accurate? I'm not even joking. It was the where you take the potion to age.
Oh, an aging potion?
Yeah, but it cuts off some years of your life. Like, he made the full reference of what it was.
The only real D&D references is a couple magic spells. But they kind of botched the names.
The
a
beholder,
bit.
But they didn't say what it was.
Yeah, they didn't ever call it a beholder.
The dwarf was not like dwarves.
Why even pay for the license if you're not going to use it?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, they basically paid for this name.
If you want to see a movie that's about Dungeons and Dragons, go onto YouTube and watch The Gamers. That's what D&D is.
You know what a better D&D movie would have been if it was like 5 characters you saw real briefly in the beginning, each one of their, how they started and how they met. And then they fight an evil army. It could have just been that.
That's Dragonlance.
And they already made it, so let's not even do it.
It's a book. They made a shitty animated hour-long special.
You know what we should watch is Left Behind.
Left Behind.
It's the Kirk Cameron
it's
Christian.
It's the Rapture.
Yeah.
Like the people left behind after the Rapture.
Which has nothing to do with what we're talking about here. But guess what?
Nick Cage is remaking that.
Yeah, I know.
Is that what you were gonna say?
No, but that's a pretty good guess what. All right, now we've come to the time where we're gonna rate the movie.
Now we're gonna rate the movie.
We rate the movie according to how many, what it's equal to in. Behind Enemy Lines,
Columbia,
which is a movie you haven't seen, right? What's the worst movie you've seen?
Oh, you're putting me on the spot.
Well, think about it. Why me and Jerry are taking our turns to rate this, because you haven't seen it, so you gotta pick a movie that's your worst to rate it. I'm giving this movie, I don't know. It's not that it was terrible, it was just boring. It was so boring. And the effects were so bad, so I think I'm gonna give it like, it gets like 28, at least 28 Enemy Behind the Lines Columbias. What about you?
Wait, so is this out of 100?
No.
What do you mean?
It's just how, like, you know, they measure.
What is 28 mean?
So,
what do you mean?
They, you
it means
know,
it's bad.
I got it. You know, they measure, nuclear bombs and like kilotons, which is like a fictitious measurement of dynamite they just invented to measure it. Well, enemy, the standard unit of measure for bad movies is one unit of behind enemy lines, Columbia.
So this movie is really bad.
So he has, what was it, 27?
28.
His is 28 units. The most we ever gave was 14 billion to,
the Holy Mountain.
To Holy Mountain. I'm going to give this 38. 38 units.
10 more than me.
Yeah. I was going to do one more, but I'm like, no, mine is at least 10 times better, so it's going to be 10 more.
I can't think of my worst movie.
Wow, Jay.
Wow, we you gave came like, unprepared. Oh
we
my
gave
goodness.
You like a minute and a half.
You focused more on what we were talking about than what you were going to talk about.
I'm trying. I'm racking my brain.
Did you see Jack and Jill?
You bet. No.
You shit me. What's the last movie you watched that was not good?
Dungeons and Dragons.
Well, how many Dungeons and Dragons are you going to give
it? One, obviously.
If I base it on.
Well,
this
we can loan you Behind Enemy Lines, Columbia, if you want.
We don't have that. That was.
No, this isn't the one with. One with Owen Wilson.
No.
WWE got the license and made it.
Mr. Kennedy, who doesn't wrestle for them anymore? I don't know who he wrestles for, if at all.
That's just like, what it did. You told it to me, but then I saw it for real. I didn't see the movie, but I saw advertisement for it. Jingle All the Way 2.
Oh, yeah.
Starring Larry the Cable Guy.
Larry the Cable Guy.
And it's a WWE production. We'll probably have to watch that.
Santino Marella, he's an American, but he acts like he's an Italian guy from Italy. So
you
he talks with
least
a bad
favorite
Italian
movie?
Accent.
I just don't got it in my brain at the moment.
Well, let's crack your skull open and see if we can't find it.
See if it leaks out.
We're going to read your mind the hard way by splatting it against the wall and then brailing it.
Sorry, folks. We're getting stalled up here because Jay can't think of a bad movie.
I blame all my past failures on Jay.
I think I'm going to give Jay 2 Enemy Behind the Lines.
Yeah, he gets 2 just for himself. Oh, no. I've never rated a person. We've never reviewed a person. That's a lot of power. I didn't realize we could do that.
Well, I mean, we're summoning clips and stuff. And
oh, God. We should review each other. The devastation.
Well, you know what? I'm making a new rule. Guests don't get to rate.
Damn,
new
Jay.
Rule. New rule. And guess what? And it's because of you.
We call it the J rule.
So, the J rule. Guests don't matter.
The J rule.
So, am I a guest my first time, but not a guest my second time?
We'll let you know.
Oh, so after the first date, he wants to go steady.
I know. He's like, hey, so what do you think the next day we're going to have sex? What the hell?
So am I one of you guys?
Oh, man.
Well, you get out, Jerry.
Yeah, I guess so. I guess you're my new girlfriend.
Yeah, he didn't think that was coming either. He thought he was going to be the boyfriend, but...
Nope.
I have.
This is the Road Warrior rules.
He's trying to tell me, he's trying to tell you.
Jerry, I have holes.
Well, you gotta tuck it. That's the only rule.
What are we talking about?
We're boyfriend and girlfriend now.
I have ample holes.
Ample.
Plenty.
Ample.
What is happening here?
I'm gonna fart.
Those are the dragons that really just chilling through. Oh.
I think that was gonna smell. I kind of feel like I have to poop.
What is happening here? What is happening to the review?
What happened to your show? We used to be such a fucking classy production.
What do you mean? You have either farted or burped in everything we've ever filmed.
I don't always touch you in every episode, though.
So what did we rate it? I got 28 and you gave it 38. So a whopping total
exempt.
Of...
I'll give it 4.
For what?
Ratings, I don't know.
Is it 4 units?
4.
He's giving it 4 units. I don't even know what the fuck that means.
But it's 4
units. I already established that his vote doesn't count, and he's giving it 4 units.
He voted anyway.
4 units, but he doesn't even know of what. Oh my goodness.
4 pounds.
What is that even the measurements? He gave it 4 pounds. Alright, well, alright, whatever. So.
So it's a total of 66 enemy at the gates plus 4x equals Dungeons and Dragons.
No.
And.
That's it?
I think we're done.
I think so too. I think this is going to be. This might be a two-parter.
Oh boy.
Who knows? You'll know if you're watching this, you'll know if it's a two-parter.
You'll never know.
Because it will end before this.
Yeah.
That's
a two-parter.
They would have known already.
Yeah, they would have already known. This would be the second thing they're watching.
They could see the future, that means.
Look at this. We're sans Jerry.
That means they can see the future.
Who?
The audience.
What do you mean?
Because if they know. Alright, so they're watching this video now. They know it's going to be a two-parter. They knew it was going to be a two-parter.
So they're watching the second one first.
This is insane. I'm turning it off. This is crazy.
They're doing it from last. Smoking.
What do you think, Lenny? What does it smell like?
It actually smells kind of good.
Yeah, I drank.
It smells like.
I just chilled through.